I was given the amazing opportunity to visit Japan and go visit distilleries making shochu last year. Shochu is amazing in that it is a parallel fermentation. It ferments both in koji using this special mold that will convert the starch into sugar, but also the standard alcohol fermentation where the yeast is converting the sugar into alcohol.
宮崎県の焼酎は500年の歴史があります。宮崎県の焼酎の特徴は温暖な気候、太陽がさんさんと降り注いで雨も緑も多い、その大地に育った芋とか米を原料にしているんで、非常に豊かな味の焼酎が提供できているんじゃないかなと思います。宮崎県の水は野山に降り注ぐ雨が地下水になってますので、大変優しい水で焼酎の酒質に大きな影響を与えるというふうに思ってます。
原料の選別から始まって、その過程の中でどれか一つ手を抜いてもやはりいいものはできないですよね。全てが重要ですよね。いいもの、原料の特徴が出てるかとかいう香りですね。味についてはやっぱり奥深さとか豊かさ、そういったものを探しながら、何回も何回も味見しながら味の変化に気づいていくというやり方だと思いますね。
焼酎の魅力は大変その神秘的な作用を麹が行って、味に厚みとか深みとかつけていくというところになろうかと思います。
焼酎 can be used in any number of ways. Certainly delicious on its own with a little bit of hot water, cold water, ice or juices, but also delicious when mixed in cocktails. Why I love shochu and use it in my cocktails is because it's so versatile. I'm able to bring out rich, savory flavors in my cocktails that I might not otherwise get in the spirits that most people use today.
Shochu gives me an opportunity to be more artistic as a bartender. I want to make very specific choices about the flavor profiles that I want to add to it and how they play together in the cocktail. Because it is so delicate that I don't want to overpower it, I want to let it shine in the cocktail.
Japanese traditionally enjoy shochu not only a cold temperature, but also a hot temperature, simply by adding hot water to it. It's going to bring more aroma and deeper flavor.
It is a product that should be on every back bar because it has unique flavors that can be enjoyed by every guest.